Carnivorous TV presents T20 Blast Volume 2. This is Tony Talk alongside the Krikon Makome, here to bring you the T20 match of the century, said Tony Talk in the commentary box. Cool intro, Tony, Makome replied as he sat alongside him in the commentary box. I call heads, shouted Captain Kimon as the elephant tosses the coin in the air between the heroic Islanders and the feared Krikons for the fate of everyone in the stadium, said Talk via the floating speaker. After winning the toss, Captain Kimon decides to bat first, opening with Nesta Fairos and himself, said Tony Talk. Six, and the Krikons start this game with a cracker, said Tony Talk in a hype tone as Captain Kimon struck a six out of the stadium. Chapter 6. We are back at Kensington Oval, Barbados, as the Krikons keep on piling on runs against the battered Islanders, said Makome. The scoreboard read 150 for the Krikons after 15 overs, no wickets. Suddenly, the elephant just clean bowled Captain Kimon, said the Makome with excitement. Well, Mako, could this be the turning point in this game? Talc replied as the Islanders celebrated at the center of the field. Chapter 7. A bird's eye view of the stadium. The Krikons erects a force field over the Kensington Oval, ensuring nothing gets in or out of the T20 blast between the Islanders and the Krikons while it is in full swing. Oh! Shouted Makome as a corkball came crashing into the stands right next to him. Being a spectator in this stadium can be quite hazardous, said a male spectator looking on. Because right now Jean Blue is on fire, said Makome with smoothness as Jean Blue stood at the crease with her bat smoking at the tip after hitting sixes. Allah, let me bowl, I can take her, said Susan Sunset, approaching Alafin with the ball in her hand. Okay, let's see, said the elephant. Susan then took to her spot and began strategizing. Try and hit this fast ball, Jean, said Susan Sunset in her mind, preparing to bowl. Chapter 8. The bales went flying behind Miss Blue. A swing and miss. Bowled! Jean Blue has been bowled out by Susan Sunset, said Tony Talk, soon after another wicket fell. This girl is on a roll, just coming into bat. Bullfrog has been bowled out. The Krikons finished on 199. Besides that lower order collapse, I still think that the Krikons made a respectable score and can still win this game, said Makome. Let's make things more interesting. After all, I'm a pirate. The Islanders will play their innings in an environment that looks like our home planet of Neptune, said Makome, as the elephant and Chris Gayle took to the pitch in their batting gear. To be continued. Look out for our story, The Last Protector of Shangri-La, coming soon. Carnivorous TV, where we bring the stories to you.
Short of the line, and the celebrations begin as the West Indies will register a win. Take them up to 4 points and the top of the table in Group A.